Welcome everyone back to my reloading bench. This is Mopar Madman, and today we're going to talk about the 143 grain ELD-X by Hornady, loaded with H4350 and varying the overall length. Stick around. Like I said, welcome back everyone. Welcome to all the new subscribers. I know there's a few of you that have joined us in the not too distant past, and so thank you for joining. I hope more do. And I hope you enjoy the channel. Today we're going to be going over, like I said, an overall length test with the 143 grain ELD-X with the Hodgen H4350 powder. If you guys have been, you know, fans of the channel for a while, you might have seen the original video I did on this bullet with H4350. And I didn't really have very good results with it. So that's kind of the reason why I ran this test. I decided that I was going to do an overall length test to see if I could get any accuracy improvement. So guys, that's, you know, without further ado, let's get right into the information. The load data that I used for this obviously was 143 grain ELD-X, the Federal 210 primer. Again, I couldn't find any match primers by the time that I actually loaded these. So there's just standard Federal 210 primer. We used 41.5 grains of H4350. That is the max load from Hornady, guys. Don't jump right into that. You know, you should be working your loads up. But I got absolutely no pressure signs in my rifle at all at that load. And so obviously I'm looking for a higher velocity load, but something that I can actually, you know, get a decent group on. So we loaded an overall length variation all the way from 288. So 2.88 inches all the way down to 2.80 inches. Just for the record, 2.80 inches is Hornady's recommended length. But if you guys are familiar at all, this is the actual projectile that Hornady loads in their Precision Hunter ammunition. So the Precision Hunter, you know, obviously is kind of, I don't know if you want to refer to it as the gold standard for this test, or kind of, I guess, the starting point or a good comparison, or however you deem to look at it. So, and again, if you guys have watched the other video, I really encourage you to go back and watch the other 143 grain video. You'll understand a little bit better why I ran this test, and some of the information might make a little bit more sense. So let's get right into it. We'll start off the overall length of 2.88. This video, I'm going to show you the spread that we got, show the target, and obviously sometimes they don't always match up the way you think they should, but this is the information, so I thought I'd give it to you guys. You know, decide for yourself. But we started off at 288. I guess for the record, my two lands overall length would have been 2894, and so we're roughly, you know, somewhere around 10 to 15 thousandths off the lands. I really haven't loaded anything to the lands on this, and honestly, at 288, those were all single hand load projectiles. I couldn't magazine feed these any. They do make a magazine. If you get the real AICS magazine, you can load that overall length, but I certainly wasn't going to buy the magazine just so I could run the test. So those were all single feed at 288. Group side wasn't impressive, 1.137 MOA. Velocity of 2,657 feet per second, standard deviation 14.9, extreme spread of 34. I should have started off with saying these were all five-shot groups except for the 280. Since that is Hornady's factory recommended overall length, I decided to test 10 of those, basically because I had 50 pieces of brass and I was going to load them all. The Precision Hunter ammunition was just over the actual Hornady books recommended overall length of 280. So back into it. So the overall length of 2870 was 1.12 MOA, 2663 standard deviation of 17 and extreme spread of 44. 286 was 0.914 MOA, so we did improve a little bit. 2650 feet per second though, standard deviation of 7.3 and extreme spread of 18. So obviously, you know, the SD and ES on that were much better. But we didn't keep getting smaller, and so If you watch the other video, all those were loaded to this 2850, but I repeated that load and I pretty much repeated my result. So, you know, I had a 2.5 inch group this time. I should have mentioned earlier in the video, 150 yards is where I shoot, guys. So 150 yards is the max range that I've got. That's close to me anyway. So that's where that's pretty much what I do all my load development at, because that's as far as I can get. I'd go further if I could. So that group, second worst of the day at 1.374 MOA. Velocity is back up to 2667, standard deviation of 10.2, extreme spread of 25. For you guys that want to nerd out, the last time I tested this exact same load, it was a little bit cooler this time. My velocity was 2648. I had a standard deviation of 14. Moving right along, 284 had a group size of the worst of the day of 1.60 MOA. 2662 feet per second, 13.4 standard deviation, and an extreme spread of 32. Overall length, we keep getting smaller here, guys. And again, too, I should have mentioned, obviously, as I got a little bit smaller, I kept looking for pressure signs just in case and didn't see any for the entire duration of the test. So the 283 was actually the best group size, so 0.759. We actually got an acceptable group out of these bullets with H4350. So 283 yielded a group of 0.759 MOA, 2652. This is what doesn't make any sense. Standard deviation of 22.5, absolutely horrible, with extreme spread of 47. Now, the 282 was pretty good, 0.844 MOA, so I can't say there was a gigantic difference between those two, because that could easily be my shooting. And velocity 2654, standard deviation did drop to 14 with an extreme spread of only 32. As we go back to the factory length, we started increasing the size of the groups again. So the 281, 1.105 MOA, 2654 was a velocity, standard deviation of 5.5 though, guys, with an extreme spread of 12. So obviously that had the best numbers for standard deviation extreme spread of the day, but certainly not the best group. And then as we went back to the book recommended length of 280, this is a more complication, guys, so you can criticize my work all you want. The first group of five was so good, I just decided to make it a 10-shot group, and I'll put that on the screen here so you guys can see it. 1.16 MOA, you know, 2656 velocity, standard deviation 11.2 for the entire 10-shot group, with an extreme spread of 30. However, if you drop the one bullet, this actually drops to 0.698 MOA. So had I not shot this as a 10-shot group, this would have actually been the best group of the day. So, where do you take it from there? Blame my shooting, blame whatever you want, or I'm not really here to make excuses. I just thought I'd put the data out there. Maybe Hornady has an idea what they're doing when they recommend that 280 overall length. The other thing I'll throw out there too, though it doesn't seem to be one of my popular videos, guys, if you haven't checked it out, you really should check out my Sierra Match King 142 grain video. In this series, its overall length recommendation is 278, which is basically like one of the shortest. Now, granted, that's Hodgen data, but man, overall, those are some of the best groups I've shot with this rifle on my hand loads. I mean, those really are some spectacular groups, and honestly, the projectile that I used after I did some more research after that video has been redone. It actually has a higher ballistic coefficient than I talk about in that video. So it actually is comparable with this projectile. So let's take a look at that one, guys. I might do some more playing. Honestly, maybe I might shrink this up a little bit. I don't know why it likes such a jump, because obviously that is a very large jump to the lands, but there's definitely some more work, and it looks like doing some change in the overall length could actually improve my groups a little bit. Also, I've also done some work with a super performance powder. I might, you know, change my overall length of my super performance load and do a little bit of a change with that and see what happens. Before I let you go, I'll talk about a little bit more of what's coming up. So you obviously see I've got two new die sets on the table. Everything that we've done up until this point has been loaded on my Lee 6.5 Creedmoor set. When I do the comparison review, which should be out hopefully in a few weeks, guys, if you stick around on the channel, you'll see I'm going to do a review and comparison of these two die sets and also of the Lee 6.5 Creedmoor set. Use a couple of projectiles out here and talk about some stuff. So if you guys haven't bought die sets yet, you might be interested in that, what comes with it, you know, what are you getting, what aren't you getting. I hope you guys like the video. I encourage you guys like, subscribe to the channel. I'm trying to get some more of this information out. I've got, you know, some new bullets coming down the pike that are coming up, some 130 grain, some 147 grain. And I've already actually shot those at the making of this video. And so as I get that information together and I can get the groups out and put these videos together, those will be out to you guys as well. So like I said, like, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you turn those notifications on if you want to see my content when it comes out. I appreciate you new subscribers. I appreciate you guys watching the video. Have a great day.